Okay. So the previous phase was anaphase. So you have seen what happens in anaphase is the sister chromatids migrate towards the opposite poles. Now in prophase, if you remember, what happened? The centrioles divide. So here the centrioles have already divided. They have come to the two opposite poles and the cell is beginning to divide. So when the cell is beginning to divide, this phase, last phase, is known as telophase. So what happens in telophase? We already know that the sister chromatids have reached the opposite poles. When the sister chromatids have reached the opposite poles, the nuclear membrane and nuclear envelope, the nuclear membrane and nucleolus, which disappeared in the first phase, prophase, reappears in telophase. So this is the nuclear membrane reappears, nuclear membrane reappears, nucleolus. So this is the nuclear membrane and this is the nucleolus. Reappears. And the sister chromatids which went to the opposite poles, the sister chromatids were the compact DNA or compact chromatin. So the chromatin which became compact now unwinds and they again become chromatin. So how many chromatids were there in the in this particular cell? There were four pairs of chromosomes, each chromosome having two chromatids. Each chromatid of four chromosomes segregated towards the opposite poles and sister chromatid now forms chromatin fibers. So how many chromatin fibers will be formed? So four chromatin fibers will be formed. Nucleolus you should not forget to draw. So this is the nucleolus and four chromatin fibers. You have to indicate the number correctly. There were four chromosomes, so you have to draw four chromatin fibers. So this is how the complete division of the DNA takes place. This is how the division of DNA has taken place already. Now division of DNA is called karyokinesis. And now when the furrow will become deeper and deeper and when the two cells will separate, so that is accompanied by the division of the cytoplasm also. So division of cytoplasm is known as cytokinesis. We will look into that after some time. But before that, see the key features of anaphase, telophase. What happens in telophase? Nuclear membrane and nucleolus reappears. Sister chromatids reach opposite poles and unwind to form chromatin fibers. So they have again formed chromatin fibers. The cleavage or furrow in animal cell deepens. What happens in plant cell? In plant cell, this is the nuclear membrane reappearing. Nucleolus reappearing, the chromatin fibers unwinding, and in plant cell, instead of the furrow formation, there is a formation of the cell plate, starts from the middle of the cytoplasm and extends towards the cell wall, towards the border of the cell. So it starts from the center and spreads out, and it starts from outside and deepens and comes, joins in the center. So this is the difference, and this structure is called the cell plate. So in the exam, if you are asked, differentiate between animal cell and plant cell depending upon what happens during telophase. So you have to say, in animal cell, the furrow, there is a furrow formation, but in plant cell there is a formation of a cell plate. There is a formation of cell plate. So this is the diagram which you must practice drawing, because sometimes what kind of questions come, suppose they give you a diagram and there you are asked to identify that stage. Suppose you have identified the given diagram on the question paper as anaphase, then the question may come that draw the phase which follows this phase. So then you have to draw telophase. So in telophase you have to show that the nuclear membrane reappears, nucleolus reappears, and the chromatids unwind and form chromatin fibers. If it is an animal cell given in the question paper, draw the animal cell only. If in the question paper plant cell is drawn, draw the plant cell only. Don't forget to draw the cell plate. Don't forget to draw the centriole in case of animal cell. No centriole you have to draw in case of plant cell. Alright, so that is all about telophase.